It's entitled Kitchen Wars because I was pretty much picking a fight with every head chef in town. I explored everyone's signature dishes, reinterpreted it, bastardized their food. The whole intention of this whole dinner was really to create some kind of like a movement. I know it's called Kitchen Wars, but I think it's something that, you know, we should try and push each other in terms of creativity. And in conjunction with Mooncake Festival, we had this dinner on the 1st of October. The dinner was presented almost like a Chinatown style. The whole place was filled with, you know, paper lanterns. Every dish was reinterpreted and presented to you in a dim sum bowl. Alright, so of course the first one was my signature cod maple syrup egg. That's always the standard amuse bouche for my degustations. Then the second course was a dish from Il Lido. So I did a trio of burrata har kow, and each one was being served with either aroma tomato concass or honey and pine nut or a caper pesto. Then next we had the la vie en rose. I adopted the sugar, the brulee, the cream, and the fagua, and I turned it into a char siu soban. Okay, then next we had Ricardo Ferrarote's mediteca. I turned it into a sweet potato bird's nest with a poached duck egg nestled in it, some fresh girolles, onion jam, and black truffles, shaved black truffles. Then next we had cilantro. And I was adapting his unagi and fagua sandwich. I presented his dish in pie tea shells, stuffed it with unagi, and then I had shaved frozen fagua on top. And this was served with liquidized arugula. Next, we had frangipani. Chris and Eddie actually came for this dinner. I was adapting Chris's tea smoked salmon that was served with roe and potatoes. I deconstructed his dish. We turned it into little siumais. And then on top we had the salmon roe. Tea component was actually a tea oil, so I used a guanyin Chinese tea oil. And on the side, the chat's potatoes were wrapped in a lotus leaf and presented to you like a lo mai gai. And then finally, the savory dish was the nero vivo. I actually stewed traditional ossobuco, stuffed it in soy gao or, you know, little dumplings, and served it in a very clear, fat-free beef consomme. And of course, Garibaldi. So what I did was I presented a deconstructed tiramisu served in a glass. And the alcohol were actually liquid alcohol chocolate balls that you had to eat, stuff in your mouth and eat with along with the tiramisu. That's it.